poradíme tady na místě.
Ano.
Hodně bude, jo, a když se nám vypsno.
Ano.
A když ty se mi propadneš po čtvrt na kůni, tak vlastně mám jeho.
With the Czech actors, and I'm just making sure that they're clear, that they're acting in English, which is a big task for any actor to act in a foreign language. So my job is to coach them to speak the dialogue clearly. And some actors, it comes easily to them, and some actors have to work pretty hard on it, especially the older actors. I have to work pretty hard, but I've been so impressed with the Czech actors because they do work very hard and they're very, very good actors. I've got to listen to every word when they're talking, because number one, David wants this to go global, this story to go global. So the English must be clear. He wants a lovely Czech accent, but not that it's drowning the English language. So I'm there to keep it clear, but not cut out the Czech beautiful qualities of the accent. And also working with the crew. I've never been around such a focused crew, and so good at what they do. And all day long they're speaking Czech, and it's like I'm swimming in Czech. I don't know what they're talking about, but it all works out. Yeah, it's been a wonderful experience. And I think it's going to be a great movie, and I'm pleased I'm involved.
Really, I was really happy that I'm going to shoot something like this because the situation in the world, especially in Europe, it's very difficult now. Like, democracy is hit it hard in most of the countries all around. The extremist parties are rising, and I think it's very important to shoot movies like this because that makes I'll say it like this, but I don't mean it. A common people think of maybe stuff that don't think daily, just something other, something different. That's what movies are good for, to make people think and realize that there are maybe more important stuff than only how to get bread and how to live from day to day. But once they don't think about history and the future bind together, even the presence can be much worse than it is.
Hraju ve filmu postavu Ludmily Polednové Brožové. A co bych k tomu řekla? Myslím, že jsem vylosovala takového černého Petra tohohle příběhu, ale pro mě je to strašně důležitá věc. V tom způsobu jednak, že jsem nikdy nehrála reálnou postavu, jakoby opravdu, že jsem se nikdy nemusela trefovat do reální žijící osoby, kterou známe. Znám její projev, jako minimálně jakoby záznam zvukovej toho, jak jako mluvila, jak se vyjadřovala. Takže to pro mě byl jako takový jakoby úkol, na který jsem vlastně se docela těšila. A za druhý je to zase jeden z příběhů vlastně naší historie české, který od dětství známe. Je to hrdinka, kterou obdivujeme, jako myslím, že všichni, kdo jsme se potkali s tím příběhem, tak ji obdivujeme. A tak těhle věci, já jsem vždycky pyšná, že můžu být toho součástí, nebo se toho vážím. Vím, že kdybych seděla v kině a nehrála v tom filmu, tak mi to bylo líto. Tak byla jsem tady velice krátce na tom place, vlastně to byly 3 dny, ale dva z těch dní byly u procesu jako soud, v reálném justičním paláci, na reálném místě, kde se to stalo. Takže to bylo strašlivě působivý a myslím si, že tady ty témata, když se točí, tak většinou působí na všechny ty lidi i na ten štáb a mají takový jako kdyby stmelující potenciál v sobě, že všichni vlastně tím tématem žijou, prožívají to a působí na ně ty reální jakoby emoce i to prostředí. A ten třetí den, že jo, je poprava, opět jako v reálný věznici, sice ne na reálném místě, kde se to stalo, ale i tak jako takový skličující atmosféře a to jsou takový tmelící prvky, jako takže štáb úžasný, David citlivý, empatický režisér a já mám ráda, když jsou ty věci jednoduchý, není potřeba někdy okolo věcí moc mluvit a stačí jenom říct míň víc a on takový je, má umí zkratku a to já mám ráda. Člověka, já se na to nemůžu dívat jako Aňa, já opravdu, mně to přijde strašlivý, já vůbec nedokážu pochopit, jak u toho ty lidi dokázali stát, jako jak se mohla jako ta žena dívat jako na ní a navíc ta Milada reálně umírala prý 16 minut. Nebylo to smrt oběšením, kdy se zlomí vás, ale udušením, ona se opravdu jako tam trpěla, jako to muselo být strašný, nechápu, jak to mohli ty lidi jako zvládnout, jak tam mohli být. Ale zároveň z tady té mojí postavy já jsem vlastně vycítila ve chvíli, kdy jsme byli na těch místech, kdy se konal ten proces a já jsem si vždycky pouštěla ten její projev, tak já si myslím, že ona tomu reálně věřila. Ona věřila tomu, že dělá dobrou věc, že Milada Horáková je nebezpečná osoba a že vlastně dělá dobře. Takže z pohledu této osoby, která stojí u popravy, já myslím, že ona vlastně se cítila dobře, že odvedla dobrou práci a že takhle to má skončit. To je pohled Brožový a pohled Geislerový je ten, že já nemůžu se na to ani podívat vlastně, ale o mě nejde.
It's not only the costume design. There's also, there's so many things I could talk about that were incredible in this, but one of them are just like the period cars and, you know, that have been so, you know, they're there, they're in the background, they're so informative of the period, and I feel like they're one of those devices that just take you right there. My very first scene on day one was the scene where I am rushing to get to Milada again before the STB do, and the end of the journey through the city is on this old 1940s trolley, and we were actually wheeling around. It was funny because at the same time, in front of the symphony building, there were these men in long top hats and coat and tails, and I didn't realize that, you know, they were clearly of a different time period. I was of the 40s and I think they were of the 20s or something. It was a little confusing at first because I didn't think they were part of our production. And it turns out it was Ron Howard shooting Einstein, the new series about Einstein, genius. And so it was just this funny juxtaposition. But anyway, I was going by on the trolley and, you know, and then I jump off and, you know, David was really concerned because it was the very first shot. He said, "If there's any danger jumping off the trolley, don't do it. We're not going to do it. Like, nothing dangerous. This is the worst thing would be for to have your actors get injured on day one, scene one." So I never told him that. I almost busted several times, particularly on the last one, which, by the way, was of course the best take because trying to recover from the stumbling and everything, I think. You know, they seemed to love that take, but didn't realize it's because I almost like totally bit the pavement. But it was really, but that was one of those things, being on that trolley and thinking you were transported, you know, into another time. You've got the rest of the folks who are there in period garb, and apart from the camera, you know, you're there. I guess just the last little thing maybe that I'll just say is it's been a real pleasure to work with Ayala. She's a really extraordinary actress, and I think she brings something really special to the role. And I'm really glad that the universe lined that up and worked it all out. You know, there's been so many twists and turns. You never know, is it going to happen? Is this going to work out? Is this not? And I really feel like on this film that. The universe has been guiding it, and maybe again something else has been guiding it, and it's all working out and has worked out exactly as it's supposed to.